deles, seja um valor.
Love Jesus all you want, just don't have to do it publicly.
Whenever the sport of football, soccer if you're American, is ever discussed in 2021, there are two names which dominate the sport today. One of those names is Cristiano Ronaldo, but the second name is Neymar Jr. Now, Neymar Jr. has recently just signed a contract with his club PSG that he will promise that he will not speak about anything that would be classed as religious propaganda. Anything that might damage the image of the club by talking about Jesus Christ, God, the Bible, he won't discuss it. Why will this be so hard for Neymar to do? Well, Neymar has been quite open about his faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. He grew up at Penny Isle Baptist Church, and rumour has it is he gives some pretty large tithes every year to the church. But what will he get in return for not speaking about Jesus Christ? Well, every single month, PSG will give him £461,000 extra to his already very large salary at the club. If he manages to do every single month of the year without speaking about Jesus Christ, he will get £5.5 million. That's a lot of money. So we do need to pray for Neymar, because he really is losing his freedom of speech. But he's not the only sports star who's been pressured into staying silent about Jesus Christ. You may have heard of Dana White, the UFC director. Well, he's told his fighters that they must not speak about Jesus Christ.
Just won the biggest fight of your career. America doesn't want to hear your thoughts on Jesus.
So what's going on here? Well, the Prince of Darkness, the devil himself, is pushing an agenda. His agenda is to make every single Christian shh, silent. He does not want the message that saves, the message which gives hope to dead men and dead women, a hope beyond the grave, Jesus Christ resurrected. He does not want that message to go out to other people. So he is doing everything he can to make the system put pressure on Christians to not speak, to not be able to be open about their faith in Jesus Christ. Right or wrong, the message of 2021 is equal rights for everyone. Is that right or is it wrong? I think many people would say that's so important. And yet when I look at the world, I look at the equal rights that the LGBTQ get, the equal rights that the Muslims get, the equal rights that the vegans get, they all get to preach their message. They all get to put out their thoughts, their content. Sometimes it's plastered right in front of our faces. And yet when a man or woman stands up and says, you're a sinner and you need Jesus Christ to rescue you and give you eternal life, that is the moment that the platform is removed and the mute button is hit. Again, perhaps you think I'm talking total nonsense right now, but I can't remember the last time I saw a normal, rational, thinking Christian give a gospel presentation on national television or any social media platform which is mainstream for that matter. I can't remember the last time I saw it. I can think of times where they put a Christian who's a bit of an oddball, who's a bit crazy, and they say this is what Christianity looks like. So the rest of the world thinks, that's a bit intense, that's a bit different. Is that what they really believe in the Bible? And yet when a man or woman looks a person in the face with love and says, there's a gentle saviour who died for you, that's very often not portrayed in the media, is it? Okay, over to you now. What's the reason why people hate Harvey Weinstein? People hate Harvey Weinstein because he abused his position of power and hurt a lot of women. Over to you now. What is the reason why people hate Ivan the Terrible? People hate Ivan the Terrible because he was a nasty, violent murderer. Over to you now. What is the reason why many people hate Jake Paul even today? People don't really like Jake Paul because he's seen as arrogant and rude. But over to you now. What is the reason why people hate Jesus Christ? People hate Jesus Christ for absolutely no reason. And Christ Jesus said it himself, they have hated me without a cause. So just do me a favour, if you do hate Jesus Christ, if you don't like it when Christians speak about Jesus, what is the reason why you are so dead against Jesus? You see, Jesus Christ, he fed the poor, he healed the sick, he taught amazing things like love your enemies. Can you imagine if all the people in Afghanistan, if all the people in America, in Britain, in North Korea, if we all practiced Jesus Christ's message of loving our enemies, would there be any wars anymore? No, there wouldn't be. You see, Jesus Christ really was a loving God who entered into this world and died on a cross, bleeding there, suffering an agonizing death so that you and I could be saved and forgiven if we put our trust in him alone. So, here's the answer you've all been waiting for. How should we, as born-again Christians, respond when the world is trying to gag us, when the world is trying to silence us from our message? What should we do as Christians about it? We need to shout all the louder that Jesus Christ died on a cross for sinners. Have you heard the name David Wilkinson before? Well, David Wilkinson was a very gifted preacher, and he was the pastor of Times Square Church in New York. Now, David Wilkinson, he felt a strong call from the Lord to go to New York all those years ago as a young man and preach to the gangs about the Lord Jesus Christ. And in particular, there was a man who David had in his heart that he wanted to reach, that he wanted to see born again under the Spirit of God. What was this man called? Nicky Cruz. Nicky Cruz was the leader of the Mau Mau's gang, one of the most violent gangs in New York. And Nicky Cruz at that time was probably one of the most dangerous men in the world. But what did the evangelist David Wilkinson keep doing? He kept knocking on the door of Nicky Cruz and saying, "Come to Jesus Christ. Let me tell you about the Savior." Until one night, Nicky Cruz came out with a switchblade and held it up to David Wilkinson and said, "You speak about Jesus Christ once more and I'm going to cut you up." How did David Wilkinson respond? He said, "Nicky, you could cut me up into 1,000 pieces and lay my body across the floor, but every single one of those pieces would cry out, Jesus Christ loves you." My dear friends, let that be you, let that be me, that nothing on earth would stop us from preaching the love of Christ to this lost world which is perishing. One final thing before you go. Whenever I do a video about the importance of evangelism, Christians always ask me, how do I share the gospel? Well, I want to challenge every single one of you right now to go out on social media, or maybe on the street even if you're brave enough, and try and share the gospel with a lost person today. Try and say something about the Lord Jesus Christ and how he died on a cross. If you'd like to see some videos of how I share the gospel, please do click here. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please do consider subscribing. We'd love your friendship here at Off The Curb Ministries.